It's the National Football League on EA Sports, and we've got a couple teams searching for their first Super Bowl. It's the Cincinnati Bengals and the Cleveland Browns, next on Madden NFL 23.
We come at you from the shores of Lake Erie. EA Sports has the coverage of the NFL from First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Cleveland Browns. And hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
Cade York set to do the honors here, and we are underway from Cleveland. And we will not get a run back here to start. It's a touchback, and it will come out to the 25. Cincinnati's offense takes the field, and leading the way for the reigning AFC champs is last season's comeback player of the year, a man who needs no introduction, Joe Burrow.
Joe Burrow could have won comeback player of the year last season simply for his statistics. 4,600 yards, 34 touchdowns through the air. But he brought the entire Bengal organization on a comeback after five straight losing seasons, first with a division title, then an unexpected AFC title, and led the team to their third Super Bowl ever. And he had them less than 2 minutes away from winning it for the first time. Keep an eye on Joey B. He expects to bring a Super Bowl title to Cincinnati in the near future.
Burrow gonna fake to mix it and now look to throw. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second and very short, Burrow. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. In for the sack, Myles Garrett. Just two plays in, and Charles already their first sack defensively.
Yeah, how about that? That didn't take long, did it? And now they look at third down, and that's another time to try and go and get the quarterback, too.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. Here's Burrow. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
So on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Fielded just inside the 30. It's a 39-yard punt, 8 on the return, and the Browns will take over, first and 10. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. Bringing this crew out, it's someone known for his big arm since he entered the league back in 2016, Jacoby Brissett.
Spent the early years of his career bouncing between starter and backup as needed, and played well, but never had a team fully commit to him as their guy. He does retain the toolbox that made him projectable as a starter. Big, strong player with a powerful arm, deceptively mobile, and tough to tackle. The best part about his game, leadership, and being a great teammate.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 37. Brissett. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
A great job defensively taking away his receivers, and he was forced to put that one into Lake Erie, but that's what good quarterbacks do. They don't take unnecessary chances if they don't have to.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. First carry for Nick Chubb, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
On third down, Brissett. And this is going to be incomplete.
I don't see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
On fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. Back deep, Trent Taylor. This will be fielded at the 17. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And the Bengals take over first and 10. Cincinnati coming back onto the field here for their second drive. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. Three and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Yeah, let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit
better. Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. They'll get four there out of the screen, and it's second down.
Nice job by the defense figuring that play out and holding it to a short game, but I don't think the offense is going to be daunted. They actually accomplished their goal there. Now they've got them aware that they can throw a screen at them. Maybe it'll slow the pass rush down a little bit, and they can throw it downfield.
To throw again on second down, Burrow. Flushed out right. He completes it to Boyd. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
We ought to just keep this line on a loop because we say it so often. First down, Tyler Boyd. He's thrived in a high-volume role for the Cincinnati Bengals, averaging almost 80 catches and 950 yards a season over the last four.
First down, here's Burrow. And that is incomplete.
Well, they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
An incomplete pass on first down, that leads to a second and 10. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 39. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first.
Barney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot cool. of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster.
Let's go, baby. Let's roll.
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 39-yard line. Burrow looking to pass. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that'll make it second down.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Looking to throw again on second down. Burrow. Boyd's the target, and he has it over the middle. Burrow to Boyd there for the Cincy first.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Morgan. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. A first carry for the former Oklahoma Sooner, Joe Mixon. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, 3rd and 5.
Count me a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
They allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss. And for the Browns, a nickel set here on 3rd down. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Boyd. And the Bengals are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
That's a sharp throw right there on 3rd down. They're looking to get the first points of the game, and they certainly don't want to be on a field goal. So that's a nice job to get the hookup and set up a 1st and goal.
From the 2, here's 1st and goal. They're passing here. Joe Burrow. Touchdown, Bengals! Joe Burrow with a touchdown connection to Tyler Boyd. And the Bengals put the Knights' 1st points on the board as they take the early lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Evan McPherson now for the PAT. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals. So that one a long 11-play drive. And it's finished off by the touchdown from Tyler Boyd. To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And he won't return. return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Second drive coming up here for Cleveland as they return to the field on offense. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here too after a good stop. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. Oh, he breaks a tackle, and he's got an alley. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A quick first down pickup. Good start after going three and out on their opening drive.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Brissett sets to throw it. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. On to the second from Cleveland. It's the Browns in control of the football, as they've got it with a second down and two coming up. Throwing, Brissett. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It'll be a pickup of four, good enough to earn him yet another first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. Oh, that's just not fair, and now room to run. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. A first down throw for Brissett. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
From the 25 on second down, Brissett, Bryant has it. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. And Chubb will try the middle here. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. They run it again with Chubb. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
vision is so important for the man in the middle, because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
That's a tremendous group effort there, because when you talk about offensive lines, the best ones talk about guys that play in harmony, in sync, and getting things done, and they did that on that play.
Yeah, especially on third and one. Got to be in sync, and they were. They'll run with Chubb, and he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. It'll be a pickup of four, and it brings up second and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. So not a lineman, but the tight end instead this time, drawing the holding call.
And more what you're getting with tight ends are guys who are much more receiver than blocker. They may be willing, but that might not be their thing. Oftentimes, they'll be the ones getting the penalties.
Quick hitter, and now a fumble. The ball's out, and the Bengals grab it. And not much on the return there. He'll take it only up to the 9-yard line.
I don't know about you, but I'm going to go to the positive side this time. Yeah, there was a fumble at the end of this one, but what a sustained drive. And if they keep stringing those together, you got to like their chances.
And credit the defense, though. You're out there for that long, you start to get tired, but they were able to get the turnover.
Did you just credit the defense?
I like to credit the defense and the offense.
I like you.
And the analysts.
That's perfect.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow. This, and he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And they will have the football deep in enemy territory all the way at the 10-yard line.
So after that sequence, if we're watching both teams' defenses, didn't it feel like a revolving door? One's on, they think they're off for a while. The other has to come on, they think they're on for a while. Then they're off, here comes the other one. Just kept turning the ball over. They've got to cut that out.
Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And they start in the best of all positions, first and goal. And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. And the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. The fumble on first down now. Here's second down. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. He finds his running back, Mixon. And he's dropped just shy of the 25 at the 24. So with the completed pass and the yardage they got, they'll decline the penalty.
So obviously, more yards on the pass completion than they would have gained with the penalty. They did the math. They did it well, and it works for them.
Keep our boys. Let's go, fellas. They go play action with Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you, in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football so far. And he's brought down at the 34, calling a gain of 4. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On 3rd and 1, Burrow dumps it off to Mixon. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him the 3rd down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
That's a big conversion there on 3rd down because they did not want to give the ball up here late in the half. They'd love to take the clock all the way down and score. This will definitely help the cause.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. To the air again, Burrow. He's got his big tight end. That's Hurst. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it's 2nd down. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Throwing again on 2nd down, Burrow. Again, that's Hurst. And they're going to have another 1st down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 41-yard line. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. And Burrow going to throw again. That's the tight end, Hurst, with it. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
Coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Now Burrow on 1st down. He's got his man on the crossing route. This is Higgins. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Now the Bengals going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number 1. Throw. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. Oh, he's brought down. And remember here, no timeouts left. They got to get to the line quick. It's a gain of a couple on what should be the final carry of half number 1. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, time for a check of the next-gen stats from that first half for Cincinnati. And their passing game has been the reason why they lead thus far. They've had great success moving the ball through 2 quarters of play. Meanwhile, for the Browns, we check on their numbers on the ground in the first half, as they know they'll need to be better to overcome this halftime deficit.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback.
Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter.
It's been a tight game to this point. What do they need to do, Charles, to break through in the second half and take the lead?
Well, I think the first thing they need to do is thank their defense for keeping them in this game. And you know what I think the defense is saying back to them? Why don't you guys focus on getting some first downs, putting some drives together, give us a little bit of a break here. If we can get some rest, we'll play even better for you. And oh, by the way, pay off a few of those drives with some points, too.
Brissett to throw on first.
That's complete to Bell over the middle. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Up the middle, it's Chubb, and a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Handoff up the middle, Hunt. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here. 3rd and 1 yard.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, a guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
On 3rd and 1, here's Brissett.
That's into the hands of Donovan Peoples-Jones. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
This offense is starting to get into rhythm. A nice quick throw there on target, able to pick up another first down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, 1st and 10. Here's the option play now to the left. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Typically on the read option play, when we talk about responsibilities, we're talking about what the quarterback has to go through. How about the inside linebacker, though? His job on this play, shadow the quarterback and hold him to a short gain. Did it to perfection.
They'll run with Hunt on 2nd down. Runs over him. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here.
14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
First and 10, Brissett. He's got the connection to Cooper.
And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 42 yards rushing for him now. He's only carried the ball four times.
In 2021, for the first time in his NFL career, Kareem Hunt missed significant time due to injury. He ended up suiting up for only 8 games, putting up 560 total yards and 5 touchdowns. Getting back to full health, he can easily double both of those totals across a full season.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Back to the ground. This time it's Chubb. He will push his way down to about the 14.
Are you serious?
Jedrick Wills, former first-round pick, guilty there. Brissett. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Amari Cooper, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Browns are an extra point away from drawing level. It took them a little while, but they are on the board here in this third quarter, and now with a chance to tie this up.
And it gives them a chance to exhale just a little bit, right? Because most of the time, if your first points come in the second half, you're often hopelessly out of the game, but not in this case. Now they have something to build on and a chance to mount a comeback.
Extra point by York is up and good. And we are tied at 7. That time, a 9-play drive. And it's Amari Cooper who finishes it off with a touchdown reception. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. After that last touchdown we just saw, Charles, we got ourselves a brand new ball game, all tied here in the third as they have their first possession of this second half.
And Brandon, this drive is all about one word to me, and that's the word answer, because they're trying to answer the momentum the other offense picked up in tying the game, because not only if they score and they feel better about themselves, they'll retake the lead and maybe set the tone for the rest of the half, keeping them in the driver's seat.
They'll try to get the run game going. This is Mixon. Up past the 25 to the 26. A gain of 5.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call, because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
Back to Mixon on second down. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 17 and a Cincinnati first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. Mixon with a first down carry. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. And now after coughing up the football, serious concerns on that sideline. Their defense surrenders the tying touchdown to start the third quarter. And now the offense follows that up by committing the turnover.
And I think you're sensing the exact same thing that I'm sensing, that the energy, much different here in the second half. We talk about it a lot, but you can feel it kind of rippling through the stadium, and it's affecting the players.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. Here's Brissett. That's to the right side and complete to Njoku. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45.
That's a nice throw there. He's obviously feeling pretty good because remember, he had a touchdown pass on the last drive, and here he comes out throwing again. And they wind up getting good yardage and a first down right out of the gate.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Ball at the 40 here for second and five. They'll run again with Hunt. And he is going to be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bengals 35. After a gain of 5, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down.
Well, partner, the defense isn't going to adjust, and they keep giving them those 5, 6, 7 yard runs over and over. They're likely to run it the whole way to the end zone. They'll be more than happy to take the yardage available and save some of their other plays in the playbook for another time.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we're back now here in Cleveland. And the question now, can they get closer on third down? A field goal from here, you're looking at right about a 52-yarder. They go up the middle with Chubb. And an excellent job of finding the opening as he's got this now all the way down to the 22. 49 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
They run again on first down. Chubb, no dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. You know what the converse is, though? You've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
On second and 11 now, Brissett. Bell brings it in across the formation. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line. Right there, he rose to the occasion late in a close game.
It's something he thought about, dreamed about, and worked on throughout his career. Because in these types of situations, he wasn't going to allow extra coverage to keep him from getting the football.
They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches. Got to kick it, right? I mean, even the short yardage, you boot this thing, don't you?
Yeah, but I know how aggressive you are. I know what you want. You want to go for it, don't you? You're feeling it, aren't you?
Yeah, but treat it like a football game, not like Madden.
I like that. Yeah. Fight the temptation, kick the field goal, because if you go for it and don't get it, you put a lot on your defense in a short amount of time.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to break our fourth quarter tie. York able to send this one through, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. So he waited on the sideline for his first chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there, a big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there and all that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
York ready, and here we go as he sends this one away. Taking it about the one. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here.
And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10
at their own 23. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. It's a gain of 34.
Well, this is where an offense needs to show what it's made of. And, in fact, where a quarterback needs to show what he's made of, trying to engineer a fourth quarter comeback. And he hits a big one right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's Burrow. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Add this game to the last one, and they move the ball over 50 yards in two plays.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. And he'll just get rid of it.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. And Thomas has it. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Throwing again, it's Burrow. And he's got Hurst, his tight end. And the Bengals are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and two.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Now it's Burrow. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner. Everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
On second and goal, Burrow. Open man is Higgins, and he's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. 4 yards on the touchdown grab, and the Bengals have taken a fourth quarter lead. This has definitely been a back-and-forth affair, and now they have the lead here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and they gave up the field goal on that last drive, as we remember, but it felt like their offense told them, don't worry about it, we've got your backs. We'll come back with a touchdown of our own, and they did.
McPherson now for the extra point. And that makes it 14-10. So that drives 7 plays in length.
And it was T. Higgins who capped the drive with the touchdown reception. To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
So now the Browns down by 4. And time, a huge factor. Plenty of time here. They've got 3 timeouts and the 2-minute warning as they've got it 1st and 10. First down throw for Brissett. Looking for Cooper. That's complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a 1st down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game.
So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get your reset. They come up on a 1st and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive.
Brissett.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And in the 2nd quarter, he may very well run by him. But in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Brissett.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
Trey Hendrickson showing off his pass rush repertoire that time.
Now the Browns will use the 1st of their 3 timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important 3rd down.
Now Brissett. And this pass broken up. But the contact well timed there. And now 4th down.
Partner, they've got 1 chance left to keep this one going. And I think for you and me, let's think along with their offensive coordinator now. Has to think back, cycle through every play of this contest, and remember what's worked and what hasn't. Because right here, he needs the best play of the game in order to keep this one alive.
Now they go for it on 4th, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have 2 timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you're going to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defenses are going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. You don't want to give them time to dance around in the backfield or run a wide sweep that'll take off time. Blitz them, put pressure on them, make sure that play ends quickly so that you can go ahead and keep moving.
Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15.
Now the Browns signal for the 2nd of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. A 1st carry for Samaje Perine. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Inside handoff to Mixon. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Burrow down to a knee, and that should be the final act of this one.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair, low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art, but maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals. And I tell you, these division games, never for the faint of heart, but they come through with a tight victory here on the road.
And you find yourself working harder in a game like this too, don't you?
Yeah,
because
ball,
you got to stay
sweat.
With it, right? You got to stay with it. You got to stay locked in. It's our type of a game. And you just mentioned it. Division game, on the road, tight, and they find a way to win it. Way to hunker down, as my old coach used to say, and find your way through.